Well, folks, today's the day. Today's the day we're putting this sumbitch back together. I'm so excited. I had such a big grin on my face last night when I came in after putting together that last video, because I'm so friggin' hyper. I'm just nutty to get this finished. Now, the base is done. I still need to install all of the components, but I'm going to do them very quickly. Now, the support rods, what I actually did, I'm really happy with what I did with these. Instead of just leaving them as just ordinary brass, what I actually did is I chucked them into my battery drill, like so, and I spun them against some coarse sandpaper and just ran it up the length of it. And the result that I got is kind of this brushed aluminum look. I don't know if you can quite make that out. You probably can't quite see it on the camera, but you might be able to see there's a difference in the finish there from the unsanded versus the sanded. And in person, they look really, really fantastic. In addition, though, I've added some foot pads to the bottom of the ship, bottom of the stand. Now, what I had wanted to do was use some of those self-adhesive silicone rubber, the little tiny feet, but God help me, I just could not find any. But I was able to find a couple of packs of just these felt foot pads. They're 1 inch, and they seem to work pretty well. The stand is nice and level. I had to trim a couple of them so I would have, one under where the shuttle bay would be and a couple under the nacelles so that it would balance nicely. Otherwise, I was just going to have some in this area, and then the whole thing might kind of be back heavy. But, it works. It fits. They're, a little bit visible on the nacelles, so I might do a little bit of trimming to kind of clean those up. But pretty much, we're ready to start installing components. So I am going to pop out the support rods, which this one has always been a bit tight, and we are going to start running some wire and installing some bits and pieces. So first up, we've got to start making some connections. This is my power socket, and I've got all of my terminals figured out. This is my positive, this is my negative, and this, I guess, would be the ground. But I'm not using a ground line, so that one will go unused. So I've got some wire already set up. I've got my soldering iron heating up. It's not quite hot yet, but I can start to make these connections already. So I like to put a little bit of a loop onto the wire so that the thing will hold in place, because I don't have any helping hands, because I really need some. I always like to do this little loop to hold it together while I'm soldering it, and then once that's done, then I just trim off the stub, and that usually works pretty well. Alright, now I am no expert when it comes to soldering. I never have been. I'm decent at it, I'm no professional. Also, get away from me, mosquito, or I will zap you with the soldering iron. I am a terrible person. So what I've always been told is you want to heat up whatever it is you're soldering and then let that melt the solder once it's warmed up. You don't want to ever touch the solder directly to the soldering iron itself. Also, I probably shouldn't be doing this on a plastic table, but I'm kind of, actually, you know what, I have a little bench, a little wood. Here we go, now we're getting somewhere. We're a real Mickey Mouse operation in this outfit. Alright, so the soldering iron is now making the connection hot. Solder is starting to flow. I could use a little flux to kind of help it flow a little better, but for this type of work, I find it's not really that that necessary. And get away from me, you friggin' mosquitoes. It is mosquito season in Edmonton. They are freaking everywhere. I was getting eaten alive by them in here the other day. Actually, you know what? That's a lie. Mosquitoes don't ever come after me, but they certainly buzz around me a lot. Alright, I'm gonna... That's actually pretty close, but I'm gonna give it a little bit more just for a little bit of extra security. There we go. That is the first connection made, so I'm just gonna trim off that little stub. And kind of trim it down so it's a little bit flatter. Now I've got some heat shrink tubing that I'm going to use to insulate the connection, because yeah, you really don't want the terminals to connect or you're gonna have a bad time. Now, you can use a heat gun for this. This is just, it's heat shrink tubing. It's literally, that's exactly what it is. It is just a bit of vinyl tubing that shrinks when you apply heat to it. And you could use a heat gun, but I don't have a heat gun. I have a soldering iron. And this works just fine. And just touch it sparingly so it shrinks just slowly and you can kind of control it. And this will act as an insulator. It will also act to keep the connection a little more permanently secured. If that solder ever were, if the solder ever breaks loose, I mean the connection is coming apart. That's, you know, there's no two ways about it. But this will add a little bit of rigidity and keep it from. It'll make it a little less likely to come apart. So that is. Some secured heat shrink. Focus. There we go. So yeah, that is our positive terminal. Now we got to do our negative. Where did my negative wire go? There it is. And I don't have a wire stripper, and I really need to get one. But yeah, this is going to be just the exact same process as the last time, so we can just kind of fast forward through to the next part. I really should have a set of helping hands with this. For those that don't know, helping hands are kind of those armatures with the gator clips on them. That they're handy for this sort of application because they hold the parts where you want them and keep them from falling apart while you're working with them. That is not very secure. Alright, so that is the second connection all ready to go. Now, I'm color coding my heat shrink so I can keep my connections straight, but yeah, you can see there. Focus. That is the second, that is the negative terminal. Come on, focus, you bastard. Dang it. Anyway, so yeah, this will be the same process as the last time. All right, so now I've got my my power supply. It's spliced in. It's not epoxied in place yet, but the wire is coming through where it's supposed to go. The negative terminal will connect to the negative line that comes down from the ship in here. The positive will go to the switch, which comes out from here. And then the switch, the wire from the switch will go back out where this black line goes, and which, again, will connect to the positive terminal coming out from the ship. So everything seems to fit nicely. It's pretty snug. The power socket is at a bit of an angle. You know, it's not flush with the angle of the nacelle, but I kind of knew that when I was going in because I couldn't really, I couldn't drill in at an angle, really. I guess I could have come in from underneath, but whatever. I mean, it's fine. So yeah, now we can start wiring up the switch and get that thing installed. So this is actually a multi-position switch. I mean, the rocker just goes back and forth, but the way it's set up, you can have power to two different devices if you wanted it set up that way. So, you know, this way would be on for this. This way would be on for another thing because there's three terminals on the back sharing a common ground. I'm not going to be setting mine up that way because I don't have two things to turn on. That said, now that this is in place, I can start to solder that connection. Again, this is one of those times when a pair of helping hands would be really helpful. But I've got my bit of heat shrink here ready for when the solder is done. And then I'm just going to have to hook up a second wire, which will connect, which will come out of this hole here, same with the black one. Then I'll trim everything up and make sure that everything fits together nicely. So let's get this one done. All right, that one is done. And now I can just come in with the heat shrink and close it up. Okay, that is that one ready to go. Now I just need to run the last red wire. All right, now that is ready. That is our last positive connection on the switch. We've got our soldering iron ready. And let's get this last connection on here done. Okay, that is my last connection on the base ready to go. Now we'll just tighten up the heat shrink. Someone's probably going to give me guff for using heat shrink this way, heating it with a soldering iron, but hey, you know, you keep your guff to yourself, you guff speaker. All right, that is all of our connections on the base ready to go. Now we can just go ahead and actually mount the ship and start connecting wires there. So let's, I gotta strip these. Actually, I'm gonna shorten these by quite a bit because they don't need to be nearly this long. Okay. Those are our connections. Those are our positive and negative terminals for the ship. Now, all I really have to do is just epoxy the switch and the power supply into place. And then I can wire the ship back onto these terminals, and then she's done. And then she is freaking done. Ha ha ha. So yes, this is getting exciting. All right, so we got our epoxy ready to go. I imagine everyone has used a two-part epoxy at some point in their lives. So I'm not gonna go into too much detail about how this stuff works, but all I'm going to say is I like this syringe type, even though my girlfriend hates it. I find that it's more controllable and less wasteful. I wasted an entire package of the two tubes type about a month ago. Because the hardener got hard on me. And that was like $20 worth of epoxy. This is like three or four. So anyway, yeah, you just want to put out just a little bit. We're not going to need a lot. Comes with an applicator. So you want to mix it up. And yeah, this is the fun and very messy part. There's no escaping it. We are going to end up with some ooze here and there. I'm going to try and be as controlled as possible and keep the schmoo from getting everywhere, but I don't know if that even got any in the connection. There we go. That should do it for the switch, or for the power socket. Now for the switch, this is a surprisingly tight fit in this hole for the switch. I thought I had left enough room for all the wires and everything to fit nicely in there and not cause a problem, but there's a little bit of tightness in there. in the back of it. But it's fine. It's fine. It's fine. Alright, we're just gonna ooze this stuff in here. That should be enough. And just lock it. It's a 5-minute epoxy, so it's not gonna take very long to cure. So I'm just gonna hold these here for a couple of minutes until it starts to set up, and then we can get on to the moment of truth. This is it. I'm so excited. This is it. The base is all wired up. All the connections are good. We're ready to mount this sucker. We are ready to remount the Enterprise. It has been years since this thing has worked. It has literally been, God, it has been 5 years since I moved out of my condo, since the last time I've had this thing on display. I built this less than 10 years ago. It has been on display for less than half of its life. And it is my favorite model I've ever done. I am so thrilled. I am so excited. I am so proud that I've been able to do this. This is the coolest woodworking project I've ever done. I have not done a lot of woodworking projects, but this is definitely the most fun one I've ever done. And doing it on video like this has been especially exciting. The last few woodworking, the last wood bases that I did, I don't think I was YouTubing at the time. This is definitely a first, and it's the most exciting, it's the most fun, it's the most dramatic base I've ever made. So I'm really happy, I'm really thrilled, I'm excited, I'm glad that you've been here with me for this. Let's get this sucker put together. This is proving to be kind of a challenging shot to frame because this ship is so damn big. Before we attach this, I kind of want to do quickly mention this. This is the panel I had to remove in order to gain access to the wiring again. I ended up using a Dremel to cut it loose with the thinnest cutting disc that I could. And then I added these tabs onto the bottom of it so that it would lock in place. Now, unfortunately, it leaves me with a huge amount of light leak. But I've decided what I'm going to do about that is I'm just going to fill this back half of the ship with a little bit of wadded fabric just as a light block layer, because there's only a couple of windows under here, and if I place the fabric correctly enough, then I shouldn't have to worry about blocking off any of these two windows or the ones down on the side. So, yeah. So enough about that. Let's go. All right, I gotta feed the wire down through the ship or through the base. I keep calling it a ship because it looks like the ship. All right. Okay, that center post is loosely in place. The front posts kind of tricky to get mounted. They're under a lot of tension, but they do fit. And there we go. That is that. Now I just need about yay much wire here, and we'll trim off about the same amount of black. Almost cut off too much. Now, moment of truth. That is all my solder done. Now, I'll just trim off little stubs. Again, I'm being careful not to screw something up, because, that would be very bad. And we'll connect our heat shrink. And now just need to make a little bit of room for some of this extra wire. this a big channel. Ladies and gentlemen, though, to be fair, well, mostly gentlemen, this is it. This is our moment of truth. How about that? Switch works. Power supply works. The flashing lights all strobe. The underside replacement panel fits in place. Eh, it's a little bit loose. I'll have to fiddle with that a little bit to get it to stay in place. I wish you could see my face right now. You can't, you know what? You can see my face right now. Oh my god, I am so excited. I am so excited. It's done, and it works. And it's intact. And it works. I'm so happy. I feel like I'm gonna start tearing up here. I haven't been able to mount this and display it in years. Literally years. I mean, it's got its flaws. It's not perfect. You know, I would have liked it if the lights on the ends of the nacelles could have strobed. I would have liked it if, you know, there's a few cracks here and there where seams have started to break. You know, just from rough handling over the years. The finish could have been a little better. You know, there's a few places where the Aztec pattern doesn't look perfect. There's a few places where it's just scratched. There's a few places where it's dirty. But I am... I'm so happy. It's done and it's fixed and it works. My god, I almost was ready to just give up on ever getting this thing lit again when I came out here. You know, I was ready to just build a new stand and call it good and just display it like that, but I spent 6 months building this thing back in 2008 and 2009. I am just so happy that I was able to make it work again. That I was able to get everything going. Ladies and gentlemen, everyone who stuck with me over the years, everyone who joined my channel way back when I first started doing this back in... Oh, Jesus, back in 2008. Everyone who's come along since then, everyone who's commented, liked, subscribed, everyone who's watched one of my videos, everyone who has criticized me over the way that I pronounce Deckel. It's Deckel. That's the way I say it. That's the way people in Canada say it. Suck it. I'm not saying decal. I'm not saying decal. I'm not saying any other way. I'm saying it's Deckel. And screw you for trying to make me change. This is one of the proudest moments of my life as a modeler. I am so excited. So that's it for this series. I'm probably gonna do a new kind of a beauty pass video like I did quite a few years ago. I did that with my old camera, my very old camera. That was like not even SD, that was like 144p. God, that thing was awful. I stuck with that for 2 years before I finally upgraded. So yeah, I'm probably going to do another beauty pass video like that one at some point in the near future. I just kind of need to set aside a place where I can do it. Some place where I can control the lighting, because I'd like to do a couple of shots where it's like dark and lit purely by itself. Because I think that would look really neat. But for now, I'm calling it. I am so proud. I am so excited. I am just over the moon, you know? Now I guess I need to dust it. All right, everybody. Thank you for sticking with me on this. Thank you for all the encouragement, all the comments, and the likes and everything. It's been fun working on this thing, working on something that's a little outside of my comfort zone, and this is the perfect way to get into woodworking. I feel like I did a really fine job, and this is going to be a good lead into more advanced woodworking projects, like doing my goddamn workbench. Which hopefully I'll be able to get started on in the next couple of months. Fingers are crossed. I just can't stop gushing. I can't wait to take it inside and show my girlfriend. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for watching. Please check out my Twitter. Please, you know, like, comment, subscribe. You know, I hate being that guy that asks for that, but here I am. I'm asking for it. Every comment I get, I appreciate. Every subscriber I get, I appreciate. You know, my channel has few enough subscribers that, you know, I notice every time I get a couple of new ones. And it's always exciting looking and seeing that number go up, which it has been doing pretty consistently for about the last 6 months. So that's good. I'm very grateful. I'm gonna stop gushing. I'm just gonna cut this off now, because I could keep rambling for hours. Thank you everyone out there for watching. Happy woodworking, happy modeling, happy creating. Couldn't do it without you.